Hey everybody, thanks for joining. So today we're talking about Zoho Everyone. And in our previous video, we talked about the user interface. So if you missed that, you can go catch up. It's a really cool video and it'll give you a good overview of exactly what the new interface is and how it works.
It will also help you get used to this new layout. Mm-hmm. So based on lots of customers that migrated from the old layout to the new layout, we created this video to give you the bottom line, how to get used to this new layout without too much pain.
Right. And we also touched on a problem with the layout. So the problem, I'll just go over it again so that you know what we're talking about today. The problem is that people are able to do things that they shouldn't in the system. And what we're going to go over today is the solution of how to fix this problem. So I'll give you an example. People can click and easily add a module. They can add different things. So if I hover over the leads, there's all these options here of things that I can create. So for example, let's say I'm an employee. I'm just clicking around and I click on add fields. So it's going to take me to edit all of the fields we have in the system. So now I realize that it's just drag and drop and I'm taking them and I'm just putting all these different fields in here. And now I'm messing up the entire leads module, the view that everyone's seeing, the view that you probably spent a lot of time making sure that it's perfect and exactly how you want it. And I'm just throwing all of this stuff in here that doesn't make any sense. And it's going to mess up the way we're working.
So in the past, for example, or in the previous version, in order for the employee to go and do that, they had to know their way. They had to go to the setup, modules and fields, the specific layout. So they had to know what they're doing. In this new view, they basically click on the plus button. They see this shiny diamond. They start to click on it. Oh, it's awesome. And then they screw up the entire CRM. The problem is that most companies do not have proper permission system. And we had many videos about it and we're teaching it all the time, but companies still say, you know, we'll do it at some point. Whenever Zoho will go to this new version, it will force everybody to be on Zoho for everyone. You must have proper permission system by that point, which means you should have good hierarchy of your company. You need to have proper permission system and you need to have proper sharing system. And Carol will show you today those steps, but you need to understand this is a serious problem that you need to fix before you're moving to Zoho for everyone.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'll show you, we'll go into the settings together. So down here on the bottom left, we have our settings. And we're going to focus on two things today, the profiles and the roles and sharing. So we'll start with roles and sharing. So this is the hierarchy that Lior was talking about. So in the hierarchy, you're going to have the different roles of your company. And so the way this works is the CEO can see everything that they've created and everyone under them has created. But for example, a sales rep, there's no one under them. All they can see are the records that they've created themselves. So it's just giving them some stipulations in the system as to what they can actually view. So let's say a sales rep can only see the leads that they are assigned to, nothing else. And there is a way to override this. So if we go to data sharing
just
settings.
Just 1 second, if you can stay there. A manager can see the sales rep. And he can see himself. A CEO can see the manager and the sales rep. So you're just cascading down. The higher the role, the more things that they can see. And this is by default the way that this role system works.
And you can override this. So if we go to the data sharing settings, you'll have the list of your modules. And so, for example, I can change for accounts. If I want them private or if I want them public, maybe I want everyone to see all of the accounts, but they can only look at them. They can't edit the data. So then that would be public read only. And then you can have public read or write, which means that they can see it and they can edit it. Or you can have public read, write, and delete. Now, it's important to know that this is also going to be dependent on the profile that they have. So if their profile says that they cannot delete, even though we have this setting on read, write, delete, they still won't be able to delete. So I'll show you what I mean about the profiles, because this is a very important part. So these profiles you can set up and you can assign to different users in the system. And this is really is going to dictate what they're able to do inside of the system. So roles and sharing is what they can see. Profiles is what they can do. So if I click on manager, for example, there are all these different options. So we have our modules here and what they're allowed to do. So the first thing I typically do is I remove delete permission on most of the items. So they shouldn't be deleting contacts or leads or accounts or anything like that. So you would just click there and you would unselect delete. You can also prevent them from exporting data on this, on the profiles as well.
Yeah, we really like to disable deleting information, because usually employees, when they're stuck and they don't know, you know, they made a mistake, instead of fixing it or telling someone, they would just delete it. Mm-hmm. And another problem is that there is a lot of theft in the in every business. And sometimes companies will have great database, and one of their employees will just export it and sell it to the competition. Yep. So we prefer to remove the exportability completely from anyone that is not very high in the food chain.
Yep. So right here we have export. So we would just toggle off of that, and they're not able to export anything now.
And from here, you can also remove the ability to create workflows and automations.
Exactly.
And all the stuff that you don't want most people to do. The bottom line is you can do it yourself. If you hover one of those eyes beside it, it will tell you exactly what this specific option will do. And you can go over it, or you can connect with a Zoho partner. We are a Zoho partner. There are lots of good Zoho partners out there. And connect with them so they can build with you the permission system. It will be a few hours' job together with you, and then you will have a good permission system with good hierarchy, and you will be good to go. But it's important to do that.
Absolutely.
So the bottom line is, whenever you are fixing all those permissions, your employees will not really be able to click on a button and add a new module, create a new workflow. We saw with a few clients of ours that employees experimented workflows, and then their clients, when they submitted new leads, started to get some BS emails because they were experimented, or some text messages being flying around to different customers every time that a record was edited. Really bad stuff. So please make sure that you are having a proper permission system, and people will understand how to use those views before you go live to this system. Super important. Is there anything else we want to cover for the permission stuff?
I think that covers everything.
I think so. Yeah. So high level, before we close the session, high level permissions. You have the profiles, what you can do. You can create multiple profiles. Can you click 1 second, go to the users? I want to show how to assign users to specific profiles. So if you go to the edit button beside the user, here I won't be able to do it, but you will see the role in the profile, and you can assign a specific role and specific profile based on the permission of this employee. And whenever you do that, they will be locked down to the permissions that you want them to have. That's it. Okay. So next video, we're going to talk about the new things that we have in this version. That's the third and last video. That will be what are the requests, the team spaces, and so on. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you in 2 days.